Riddle me this. What do goats, poliovirus, and corn have in common? The answer is we learn much of their cellular mechanisms and components all thanks to SDS-PAGE. So then, what is SDS-PAGE? SDS-PAGE stands for sodium Dodecyl sulfate-polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. It is a method used to determine molecular weights of polypeptide chains in oligomeric proteins. And since its discovery, SDS-PAGE has assisted in new discoveries and advancements in all these wonderful things and more. So how did SDS-PAGE come about? It was the 60s and science was on the rise, but it was a struggle to determine protein weights. The most frequently used method at the time was gel filtration in guanidine hydrochloride solution, which yields reliable protein weights, but the whole procedure can take up to 4 days. To resolve this issue, Arnold Chaparro, Eladio Venuela, and Jacob Meisel proposed a much more efficient alternative. You guessed it was SDS-PAGE. They proposed that separation of proteins depends on their molecular weights, and their masses can be distinguished by polyacrylamide electrophoresis in an anionic detergent like SDS. This news traveled all the way from New York to Massachusetts and into the lab of Klaus Weber and Mary Osborn. They then repeated Chaparro and team's experiment to test out its validity. So let's talk through the steps. Step 1. Preparation of protein solutions. 40 well-characterized proteins were prepared by incubation with buffer solution containing SDS and other chemicals. SDS is an anionic detergent that breaks down the protein's globular structure and mutes the protein's varying charges with its largely negative charge. This eliminates charge as a protein migration determinant, leaving weight as the only determinant. Step 2. Preparation of gels. Weber and Osborn prepared the acrylamide gel by making a concoction of these chemicals. They then filled sterile clean glass tubes with the prepared solution and water was added on top, and the gels were left to harden. Now, what makes polyacrylamide gel a great supporting matrix is its relatively small pores that act as a sieve, which allows smaller, lighter molecules to pass through faster than larger molecules. Step 3. Putting it all together. To track protein location, tracking dye solution consisting of these chemicals were added to the protein solution prepared in step 1. The solution was then applied to the acrylamide gels made in the previous step. And finally, electrophoresis was conducted at a constant current. Step 4. Staining and destaining. Staining helps us locate the distance of protein migration, and destaining removes the dye from any protein-free region of the gel. Weber and Osborn stained the gels with Kumasi Brilliant Blue Dye solution. They then destained the gels with a destaining solution made up of these chemicals, so that we can go from this to this. And finally, step 5, calculations and analysis. Weber and Osborn recorded data obtained from their gel samples and calculated for protein mobility using this equation. They then conducted series of analyses and found that Chaparro, Vinuala, and Meisel were right. Protein mobility can in fact be used to determine their weights. But what makes Weber and Osborn's study so significant? It wasn't because they repeated another researcher's study, rather, it's the ideas they brought forward. 1. Weber and Osborn illustrate that the results produced by SDS-PAGE are highly reproducible. Now, reproducibility is very important because it strengthens and verifies the theory by demonstrating consistency in the data produced, even if the experiment was to be repeated by other researchers. 2. Weber and Osborn are confident that the molecular weights obtained from SDS-PAGE are reliable and accurate, and yields excellent results for protein samples with various native states. They stated that SDS-PAGE yields an accuracy of better than give or take 10% for polypeptide chains whose molecular weights lie between 15,000 and 100,000 Daltons. 3. Weber and Osborn proposed that SDS-PAGE is more superior to gel filtration with guanidine hydrochloride for 2 reasons. 1. The protein weights can be obtained within a day, contrary to 4. And 2. Very tiny amount of protein samples are needed. In this experiment, Weber and Osborn applied just 0.01 mg of protein per gel and insisted that the amount could be even lower. Of course, the technique did not exist without limitations. Certain aspects of gel filtration by guanidine hydrochloride remained superior. Weber and Osborn proposed that, as the technique was new and still under development, more research still had to be done for us to clearly visualize functions and mechanisms of SDS-PAGE. Whether in the study of corn, chicken, medicine, or even us, we owe it to the excellent works by these glorious researchers and their roles in advancing our knowledge of SDS-PAGE. And that, everybody, is the wonderful world of SDS-PAGE and a snippet of its magnificent history. Isn't science the greatest?